Okay, it's April 17, 2018. It's around 11 o'clock a.m. I just planted an herb called purple coneflower. I'm gonna show up on there. Right off the steps, both sides out, about 2-3 feet roughly. I got 4 clocks on the very ends behind where those bush stubs are. We cut up all the bush. We're going to dig it up in the fall. We cut up 2 already, dug them up. So, just behind that bush stub. There's a bunch over there, like 6 over there, or 4 over there, 4 or 5 over there. The same thing over here, right by that gutter, behind that bush, that little cut up bush. There's 4 or 5 over there also. And then closer to the yard from the porch, like I said, the herb that's a purple coneflower is 3 feet from the steps away from each end. And I've got 2 other flowers that, next to those. I have some in my pocket here. I don't know if this is seeds for them or not. Yeah, the herb calendula. Again, that's coming out. That's an herb. That's the ones that I planted next, or on the far end. So that's what we have planned out here in the front yard. I don't know if this even comes out with my voice because the wind out here, I got my face covering up the outside without an air. So I'm gonna go outside, breathe in that air, come out sometime at nighttime with a real powerful beam flashlight and shine it out there and look at what's coming down in the sky. And tell me it's just pollen. And if I see you, I'll hit you right in the throat. Tell me it's just pollen. That's what stupid people say. I don't like stupid. Side. Like I said, right now I just put one seed. I can't see on this viewfinder because, you know, it's a Sony and they kind of do this stuff purposely. Where's it right there? There's two spots we can see. Matter of fact, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take this camera off of this tripod. Walk away without a cane. But yeah, right there's a torch, right there's a torch right in the center there. I just dug them up about 4 inches, 5 inches, and I put dirt back in there. I just put the seed about 1/2 inch underneath the top soil. See, some of these flowers here are going to go on the side like this flax. That's going to go on the side. This is going to go out on the side. I don't know if it's going to go outside or in the front. This snap. I can't even read this thing. Gosh, like flowers, snapdragon, mixed colors. I swear, some of these flowers are just unreal. Most of them are herbs. So they have medicinal purposes. So that's how it's going to go in the front garden. You know, and like I said, in fall, we're going to dig up these bushes like that one right there and one on the other end about the same size. We cut up 2 already and pulled them out about a month ago. And these 2 will come out in probably October if we're here that long. One here and one on the other side behind those rose bushes. So you can see the lines here, basically. That's how the flowers are put in. Three separate sets. Or 3 separate types. And like I say, right here is where the 4 o'clock are over here. Behind that one, the same thing on the other side over there. So I put the typical yellow sunflowers in my sunflower fence, border, whatever you want to call it. Now I can't see on this viewfinder again. That line right there. Most of the way back, and then I put torch near the corner. And then the back corner is yellow, and then I did torch all the way across the back. That's about 65 feet across. And then I did the torch over by Lucy and CJ's graves. The orange flowers, you get the hummingbirds, the honeybees, and the large winged butterflies. So when they come out, about June or so, I'll come out here and, well, I'll be out here before then too, but I'll make sure I get another video of just the flowers around the garden. So we got about 127 garlic over there, folks. Heirloom garlic. Heirloom garlic. 127. So. And they're all growing good. Oh, that's it.